KTS Tulsi. Now you can take only 3 minutes.
I hope it will not be considered disrespectful to my esteemed friend. Entertaining as I do, views quite different from his. In fact, I rise here in support of the bill, and I want to compliment the Law Minister for having taken on this responsibility on his shoulders to undo the disturbance of balance in the constitutional framework by 1993 judgment. It has taken us 24 years to restore the balance. And the system of judges appointing judges is just not contemplated in the Constitution. On the other hand, I would like to refresh the memory of this August House with the words of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, which were, this is what he said, that to allow the Chief Justice practically a veto upon the appointment of judges is really to transfer the authority to the Chief Justice, which we are not prepared to vest in the President of the Government of the day. In spite of the fact that in the Constituent Assembly this matter was debated, and the question of the Chief Justice or the judges being able to appoint judges was squarely and roundly rejected, yet the judges took over the power from the executive. I would like to say that it should not degenerate into a turf war. It's not a question as to who appoints and which person has the last word. The matter of utmost importance with regard to appointment of judges is the transparency, the manner in which they are appointed. And transparency will come if one day we are able to adopt the system like the way the parliamentary committee would hear the objections against the nominees of the commission and then decide. There needs to be a joint committee of the parliament which will entertain the objections, hear them publicly, and take a decision, give an opportunity. Ultimately, the power of appointment of judges must vest in the parliament and in the representatives of the people. Thank you very much.